reflect on how good you are, how faithful you are, how your mercies and your grace are always with us at times when we even don't deserve it. We praise you. You are worthy of it. Thank you for putting on that. Thank you for the trials and tribulations. Thank you for moving us in the preparation for this coming new year. I pray this year will be a blessing. A blessing for each and every one of us gathered here. And for your church, and for your kingdom, and for your goodness to be seen in each and every one of our lives in this community, in this state, in this world, Lord Jesus. And thank you for your promises. Thank you for the promises when we fulfill this coming new year. We submit ourselves before you. We submit the rest of the service before you. I ask this room in a mighty way. We thank you and praise you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
स्वर्गीय पिता हम तेरा धन्यवाद करते हैं सुंदर समय के लिए परमेश्वर तेरी उपस्थिति यहाँ पे हम महसूस कर सकते हैं परमेश्वर तूने हर एक समय परमेश्वर हमारे साथ हम सबके साथ है परमेश्वर इस साल भर हमारे साथ है परमेश्वर हमसे रहती हुई गुनाहों में कुछ माफ भी करे तेरे पवित्र आत्मा हमारे साथ होता है जहाँ भी हम जाए सब परमेश्वर मांग करें खासकर बच्चों को तेरे हमारे सामने बचा के रखो परमेश्वर एक साथ परमेश्वर जो कुछ भी होता है परमेश्वर तेरी इच्छा के अनुसार होता है तू हमें तैयार कर रहा है प्रभु जी इस राज के लिए परमेश्वर हम धन्यवाद करते परमेश्वर तेरा इस सुंदर समय परमेश्वर जो दो बहनों ने बपतिस्मा लिया परमेश्वर तेरे राज की आने के लिए परमेश्वर तूने उनको तैयार कर परमेश्वर उन परिवार को परमेश्वर देख के परमेश्वर राज के इस्तेमाल कर परमेश्वर हम धन्यवाद करते हर एक लोग जो यहाँ उपस्थित है परमेश्वर पवित्र आत्मा उनको छू के बाधे करे परमेश्वर धन्यवाद करते परमेश्वर आज का परमेश्वर जो कुछ परमेश्वर प्रोग्राम हो रहा परमेश्वर तेरी उपस्थिति यहाँ पे परमेश्वर तेरी महिमा हो परमेश्वर हम घटे तू बड़े परमेश्वर इस सुंदर समय परमेश्वर एक बार फिर तेरा अपने आप को समर्पण करते हैं सब कुछ आप ग्रहण कर परमेश्वर हमारी छोटी सी प्रार्थना सुनो यीशु मसीह के नाम से मांगते सुनो और ग्रहण कर पिता
आइए हम सब मिलके एक गीत गाएंगे हे परमेश्वर मेरा पिता तू सब मिलके हम ये गीत गाएंगे क्योंकि लैंग्वेज किसी भी तरह का प्रॉब्लम नहीं होना चाहिए क्योंकि हाँ मैं एक बात कहना चाहता हूँ कि प्रभु ने हमें इस साल की शुरुआत से लेके अभी तक प्रभु ने हमें सुरक्षित रखा इसके लिए हम प्रभु यीशु मसीह के धन्यवाद और आराधना करते हैं और एक और बात जो भी हम लोग अभी इधर है यहाँ खड़े ये सब उसकी दया और कृपा के कारण है हम सर्वशक्तिमान प्रभु परमेश्वर की स्तुति और आराधना हम करते हैं सब मिलके करते हैं हालेलुया
हे परमेश्वर मेरा पिता तू स्वर्ग निरंतर स्तुति तेरे करते धन्यवाद के साथ में सदा तेरे पास Ooh.
Sister Belgender, please come forward and hear us pray.
जो तुम्हारे अगुवे थे और जिन्होंने तुम्हें परमेश्वर का वचन सुनाया है उन्हें स्मरण रखो और ध्यान से उनके चाल चलन का अंत देकर उनके विश्वास का अनुकरण करो।
बाइबल बता रहा है उन लोगों के बारे में जिन लोगों ने तुम्हें उंगली पकड़कर चलना सिखाया, उसकी बात कर रहा है। मैं अपनी बात करता हूँ, आज से 4 साल पहले मैं जब इस चर्च में आया तो जब वचन की घोषणा होती थी ना तो कोई भी वचन बोलते थे तो मैं बाइबल खोलता रह जाता था, बाइबल को ऐसे पढ़ता रहता था जब तक पास्टर जी अपना वचन पूरा करके फिनिश कर देते थे, क्योंकि मेरे को कुछ भी मार नहीं था। अगर मैं धन्यवाद करता हूँ इस पूरे हिंदी चर्च का और पास्टर जी का, जिन ये ब्रदर का जो मेरे घर पे जाकर मेरे को मैसेज छोड़ छोड़ कर मेरे को बताते रहे कि ऐसा है ऐसा है। मेरे को एक बात याद है कि ब्रदर को मैंने एक यूहन्ना फर्स्ट का चैप्टर 14 मारों ने कितनी दफा इससे क्वेश्चन किया कि मेरे को एक दफा फिर इसका मीनिंग बताओ, फिर मैं फिर दूसरे भी का ना फिर मैंने इसको बोला। मैंने एक दफा मैंने सोचा ब्रदर कहीं कोई ना हो अपसेट ना हो जाए कि एक ही बात बार बार पूछते हैं, मगर उन्होंने मेरे को इतने तरीके से समझाया कि मैं इसका बहुत धन्यवाद करता हूँ, क्योंकि पूरा चर्च हिंदी चर्च सिस्टर रमन वो कभी भी जब मेरे साथ बैठती थी तो मेरे को एक ही बात बोलती थी कि अंकल मैं जब आपसे बात करती हूँ तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है जैसे मैं अपने बाप से बात कर रही हूँ। बहुत तरीके से मेरे को इन लोगों ने समझाया, मैं इसका इन सब का धन्यवाद करने के लिए इधर खड़ा हुआ हूँ कि मैं सबका धन्यवाद करता हूँ कि मेरे को इस जगह पे खड़ा होने के लिए इन लोगों का बहुत बड़ा योगदान है। और एक पवित्र बाइबल बताती है कि इन आगुओं की निष्ठा की रीस करो। मैं आप सबसे प्रार्थना करता हूँ कि मेरे लिए प्रार्थना करना कि मैं भी इन जैसे इन लोगों के जैसे जिन लोगों ने मुझे उंगली पकड़ कर चलना सिखाया है इसके पीछे चलने के जो बनाए मैं इसके सीख कर इस जो जैसे ये चलते हैं ऐसे ही चल सकूँ। यही मेरा
Brother is so thankful to the church. When he first came to this church, he was just like a baby. He didn't understand the word. When the ministers preach, he just look at the word and don't understand. And then he was so thankful to the pastors that who came to his house. He keep on asking the same question over and over. Just for example, that he couldn't understand easily from the words that is. John chapter 1:14. Can anybody read that verse? Sister Jody, can you read that? John chapter 1:14. Jesus came to this world. God himself became.
Word
became flesh. That, yeah, simple as it is, the word became flesh. The brother couldn't understand what is exactly the word of became flesh. What happened? And he was keep asking me, and we were able to share with him and teach him, and now he can preach, and he's an evangelist. He's going to be an evangelist. He's going to preach, and he has a church to pray for.
Greetings, Señor, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It is so wonderful. To come into the presence of God. It's the first time, only one time we come together as a whole church in this independent, sometimes they leave. And just some Malayalam church people also leave. So we never able to come together as one church and together to worship God. This is the time. And I thank all of you to put in the effort and to share what God is doing in our life. God is doing wonderful, great work in this city, in this consulate area. And as you know, many people, we share the gospel with them, many people in this community, and through videos and the other activities, and we go house to house. And we still believe in house to house visit, and we still do, and share the gospel like that. And I thank God for it. There are many people, especially that Kashmir Singh, who's just heard his testimony, a great prayer warrior. They both pray a lot. They both pray a lot in the presence of God. Just step by step, he growing in the presence of God, and he became a great prayer warrior for this community. And God is blessing him also. And God is blessing him, and he experienced that numerous miracles that he can share in his own life. He didn't have the time to share the whole stories about his family and how much God is blessing him in that level. Tonight, last year, I believe 3 years ago, we started offering in the New Year's Eve service. We don't usually have that before, but recently we started that. The purpose was to go to the mission field, the work for the mission works. And I thank all of you actively involved in the mission field. And we do sponsor churches, orphanages, and we have television ministry, we have a Bible college sponsorship, and we have two places, we have a sewing machine and training how to do make the clothes in the villages and train them. And we have those, and we do all those ministry we support in different parts of our world. So God, the offering which we are about to give it to the Lord, while the Malayalam worship team will be leading that song, and please come and while the believers are getting ready and to write the biggest check of 2016 to 2017, worship team will be getting ready. And one thing I always share with you, I never tell you something I don't practice. And I do, and I do, and the people in the leadership, they know very well, and I do give it to the Lord. I have three checks I wrote it today. One is for the mission field, one is for the, I do not have the money to give the full tithe to last year, last month, there was some water came to my car van, so I had to use it. So I did only half of this tithe I paid that time to make up for that, then money for the building fund. So three checks I brought it, and I hope and pray. I'm not sharing that because I gave all, because I wanted to tell you there is a blessing when you give it to the Lord. It's very important in life as a pastor, and it's my responsibility to teach you, because nobody else can tell you that. Start to give it, you will see how much you will be blessed. But our worship team will lead us in prayer while we give it to the Lord in an offering.
Praise the Lord, hallelujah. As we take the offering, we sing a worship song, and everybody can join, clap hands. Language is not a barrier. It's God who matters. Hallelujah. Today we can worship the Lord. He is faithful thus far. We can all join together and sing a song. And when the offering is taken.
Hallelujah. And the parents.
could you please come? We want to wash your feet. In order to know some experience, for everyone is an awesome experience at the same time. People like this church, people were there, they did not feel that they knew because they see that of me here. Many churches, when the Holiness Movement took place, 1906, in Assusot Street, from there the Pentecostal movement came to all over the world. At the very same time, this movement took place in Africa, India, South America, Europe, and every five continents. At the same time, the movement of the Pentecost came. From there, the Holiness Movement came, and then it went on name change, and naturally, from generation to generation, over 100 years, the foot washing ministry vanished from many churches. So a question came to me when I took the leadership, do I continue? Because nobody needs to wash your feet anymore, because I'd rather wash the car. Young generation many times say, what is the purpose of this? Wash my car instead of washing my feet. Because I don't need to wash my feet, because my head is already clean. So what is the purpose? So the question came to me at that time, either get away with it and throw it out and to move on, or continue. I choose to continue. The reason, I do not want my generation or the minister, the children who are growing up in my ministry, go to a conference, washing the feet, and they will say, I never seen this in my whole life. Because it is in the Bible. Jesus himself. At night, when they were sitting in a Passover meal, Jesus took his outer garment and he took a towel. He went to the disciples. I wanted to wash your feet. I wanted to wash your feet. He washed all the disciples' feet, including Judas. He washed it. Then he came to Peter. Peter is always like the seconds. You know, like many other people. You know, they want, he talked fast before him. Peter said, hey Jesus, Master, Lord. He's the one in there, a couple of days later. He said, don't wash me. So don't wash me. I don't want it. I don't want you to humble yourself in front of me. But Peter did not realize it. This Jesus only humbled. He left the glory and came down to this earth. But he was teaching Peter. Peter, you don't understand this now. Let me do this for you now. You will understand later. My friend, it is not a ritual. It is a ministry. Telling the other believers, I am willing to serve you. As a symbol, if you want me to wash your car, I will wash it. And I help you to have the need to do that. And don't say, they won't bring your car. That's a different issue. But the symbol is letting them know, I am willing to serve. My friend, Christianity is a ministry of serving. Jesus served. Jesus served. So we wanted to serve. So next couple of minutes, the place is ready. Women can go downstairs and men can go on the other side. Please, when we go there, do not entertain in talking, speaking about other things. Listen to me, adults, parents, your children will do the same thing what you do. You talk, disrespect the presence of God, your children will do the same. And I see that every time in my life. So next couple of minutes, just to keep the same atmosphere as here, just go and wash the feet as soon as possible, so we do not waste our time. We have a beautiful time tonight in the presence of God. We want to continue that tonight. So this time I invite the Hindi worship team to lead that song at that time. And everyone, you are free to go on the other side, but do not chit-chat there. Have the presence of God and have the attitude of worship. Sounds you can hear it. So the music and the worship is, you can hear it there. Sing together and come back as soon as possible. So we can, I know I have a time, I know how much it takes. And so everything is set here. So it will not take more than 15 minutes, I know that. So you will come back and we can go directly into the communion right after this. Please feel free and you can go now. And do not, everybody here doesn't need to go right away. And 25, 50 people can go now. And 50-50 is good to go. And so 15 minutes, easy, we can finish it. Our Hindi worship team and a couple of three or four people from the team and to come and sing. At that time, others can go. When they come back, the others can go. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Shukriya. Mere Prabhu
2016, and thank God for the blessings in our life. Separating a couple of hours, remembering the grace of God in our life. It's 10:30 now. 1.5 hours left for 2016. All the ministry on the other side is done. Next hour and a half, I need your undivided attention. Young children, adults, parents, next hour and a half, we are concentrating on two things: Lord's table and the Lord. We will be spending some time in worship. The worship team will take us to that presence. Let us all join together. Finish up 2016. Remember the grace of God in our life and look forward at 2017 with His favor. It's the rest of the time. I cannot want anyone on the other side. I need you here. I need you to sit with the reverence. The glory of God is in the sanctuary. The presence of Jesus Christ is here. Hallelujah. Give Him the respect due unto Him.
Hallelujah.
Let's listen to the word right before we go to the communion. What it's all about. Then we go forward, go forth from there.
Praise the Lord, everybody. It is 10:30 at night. Many people are tired. I stifled it on myself. I wanted to. But I am excited as well. Like the pastor said, it's really good for everybody in the church to be together and worship in all our forms and languages all together. It's a big mishmash of languages, but our God loves it. Every minute. And just like the pastor said, the next couple of minutes, from now till 12, no more jokes, no more playing around, no more talking. From this point onwards, we will put our complete focus on the Lamb of God. First Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23. Someone read that, please.
From the Lord, what I also passed on to you, the Lord Jesus, on the night He was betrayed, took bread.
That's it. For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night that He was betrayed, He took bread. Every time we have Holy Communion, almost every time, we read this passage, 1 Corinthians chapter 11. It's not because there aren't other passages that describe the Last Supper. Almost every gospel has it. But Paul takes the time to talk about the importance of the Lord's Supper and why it is important. And I want to bring your attention to a very important phrase that Paul uses there. For I received from the Lord, but I also delivered to you. That phrase is very, very important. Paul uses that several times through his epistles. But I want to move forward. How does Paul describe when this event took place? It happened on the night that he was betrayed. There are so many ways Paul could have described that night. It was Passover night. It was the night that Jesus washed the disciples' feet. It was the night of Jesus' most intimate teaching with his disciples. It was the night that Jesus sweat blood in the garden. It was the night where Jesus yelled at his disciples because they couldn't stay awake all night long with him. But Paul uses this phrase to describe that night. What happens later on, the day that Jesus took bread and gave thanks was the day that he was betrayed. Betrayal is a strong word. It generally means that something that you trusted, something that you thought was okay, something that you put your belief in, turned out to be wrong, turned out to be false, and turned out to be someone that hurt you or damaged you. Betrayal hurts more than almost anything else. Here's why. An enemy cannot betray you. A stranger cannot betray you. The only people that can betray you are your friends, your family, and the people that you bring into your circle, into your life. The people that you decide to put your trust and put your belief into, those are the only people that can betray you. I want you to know something. On that night, it was not the Pharisees and it was not the Roman soldiers that betrayed Jesus. It was not the chief priests and it was not the Jewish people that betrayed Jesus. It was one of Jesus' own. Someone that he spent time with. 3 years, he poured himself, he imparted himself into his disciples. And I know everyone talks about Judas here, but I want to talk about every one of his disciples, because not one of them stood up with him when he needed them. The Bible says that every one of them abandoned him. What you believed, what you trusted, was not true. Someone turn to Psalm 55 and read verse 12, 13, and 14. Psalm 55, 12, 13, and 14.
If an enemy were insulting me, I could endure it. If a foe were rising against me, I could hide. But it is you, a man like myself, my companion, my close friend, with whom I once enjoyed sweet fellowship at the house of God, as we walked about among the worshippers.
The psalmist says, if it was an enemy who did this to me, I could bear it. If it was somebody who hated me, somebody who I knew didn't like me, someone who I kept at a distance, I could understand. It would still hurt, but I could understand. But it wasn't an enemy. It was you, a man, my equal, my companion, my familiar friend. We used to spend time together. We used to have counsel together. We used to walk in the temple of God together. We used to worship together. We used to be in fellowship together. You were the one who came and betrayed me, is what the psalmist says. Jesus expected threats and danger from his enemies. And that's why they did not know where Jesus was at night. Only his friends, Only the ones that Jesus trusted knew where he was that night. And that's why only one who was his friend could come to him in that night and betray him. Who betrayed Jesus that night? We all know Judas sold out Jesus for 30 pieces of silver. But I want to ask you this night, what about you and I? 2,000 years ago, the body of Jesus was stretched out on a tree. And all the curse of humanity and the world was placed upon him. Every drop of his blood was shed down onto the cursed earth for us. And then, much more recently, it might have been a few weeks ago or it might have been a few decades ago, whenever it was, for me, it was August of 1991. Like Nina spoke this morning, a message pricked my heart. And I realized I needed a Savior. And on that day, when I asked Jesus to be my Savior, that day, do you know what he did for me? He brought me into his family. He took off my dirty clothes and he put his clothes on me. When I came up out of that water, I was clothed in Christ. Then do you know what? He gave me his last name. He made me a part of his family. He took me to his house and said, this was my house, now it's your house. Then he gave me authority. He said, whatever you speak on this earth, if you bind something on earth, it will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. He gave me authority. He gave me love. He gave me his trust and his belief. All of us can say that. If we have stepped out of that water, we are part of his family. We have been given the precious, precious things of God.
Hallelujah.
And how many of us, just like Judas, have sold him out? For Judas, it was 30 pieces of silver. What did you and I sell Jesus out for? To us, what was more important than the trust of Jesus? It might have been money, might have been a job, might have been your family, it might have been your studies, it might have been your, you know, whatever you have. But each and every one of us took something in our lives and we made it more important than God. And we betrayed him. He trusted us. He gave us what was most precious to him. And each and every one of us, we betrayed him. We took that trust and we said, this is not important to me. What the world offers is more important to me. We each have said that. And that's why Paul describes it. On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and he gave thanks. I don't know where you are in your relationship with God. I don't know where you are with your relationship with Jesus. You might be in a state of betrayal. You might be in a place where you're far away from where you used to be. You might be in a place where you used to have so much enthusiasm and so much love for God, but that's cooled down. But I want you to know, even in that betrayal, Jesus calls out to you. It's not too late. As long as we have breath in our bodies, as long as our heart is beating, as long as he has not appeared yet to take his bride home, we still have time, church.
Hallelujah.
And that's why, like Pastor Ben says all the time, it is not Pastor who stands behind here. It is Jesus. And he calls out. No matter where you are in your relationship, no matter what you sold Jesus out for, church, I want you to know, Jesus calls out to you. This table is available. No matter where you are in your relationship, Jesus says, it's not too late. Come back.
Hallelujah.
Choir, come on.
Hallelujah.
I want you to know, church, that this invitation is open. And we're going to take a couple of minutes to really think about what God calls us to be. To really think about where we are. The Bible says, examine yourselves. This table is not available for anyone to just come just as you are. take a minute. Find out where you are. Take a minute. See where you are in your lives. Is there anything more important to you right now than the love of Jesus, than the relationship you have with Jesus? Is there anything that you are holding more important? Is there anything that is blocking your relationship with Jesus? This is the time. Please don't reject this moment. Take a moment right now and examine.
Ministers who ministering, please come. Let's read Isaiah, book of Isaiah, chapter 53. To reminding us what our Lord suffered.
Praise the Lord. I will be reading from Isaiah chapter 53, verse 1 through 6. Who has believed our message, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up before him like a tender shoot and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and familiar with suffering, like one from whom men hide their faces. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he took our infirmities and carried our sorrows. Yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Praise the Lord. Let's bow our heads and pray. Hallelujah. Loving Heavenly Father, Master, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for the sacrifice. Hallelujah. You have given on the cross of Calvary, Lord, for our iniquities, Lord Jesus, our sins, mighty God. Thank you for redeeming us, Lord. Enable us to understand, Lord, the sacrifice of the cross, Lord. Enable us to love each and every one of us as you desire, mighty God. We pray that you forgive our shortcomings, mighty God. Open our eyes, Lord. Hallelujah. Cleanse us, Lord. Hallelujah. We give you all the glory. We bless this hallelujah meeting in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. The meetings, hallelujah, Father, let your grace and presence be here, Lord. All the glory to you, all the honor to you. Everything we ask in the name of Jesus Christ.
This is Lord's table. The Bible reminds us who can partake. If you are an individual who accepted Jesus into your life as personal Savior, publicly displayed that love to Jesus through baptism in the name of Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, experiencing the fullness of the Holy Spirit, or have a desire to experience that also, presence of Holy Spirit, living a holy life that pleases to God, anxiously and prayerfully waiting for the coming of the Lord, you can partake this table. Otherwise, stay away from this, because there is blessings in this. Because Jesus accomplished great blessings and released that upon the people. While we partake this table, we will be able to experience that in our life. Forgiveness of sin that we experienced through the cross of Calvary. The peace, there's no man can give that peace. The peace of God we are able to experience. We are able to say we are a children, a family of Jesus Christ. Jesus broke the barrier so we are able to call him Abba, Father, and call him Dad. We have the freedom to do that because of this table. Physically, emotionally, spiritually, if we are sick, Bible clearly teaches us by the stripes we are healed.
So while we partake in the Lord's table tonight, my prayer is, if there is anyone who are listening or who partake in this, not able to receive the healing, my prayer today, God, hears, because there is power in the blood of Jesus. My friend today we spoke. This reminds us there is hope. This reminds us death is not the end. There's life after death. There is one day we will be in heaven with the Jesus. Jesus said that day we will do this together. Until that, we as a family of God pray the prayer together. 2016, one more opportunity we have received to pray the prayer together. Could you please stand with me this morning while the worship team take us into the presence of God? Praise God. The Lord Jesus of the night, he was betrayed, took the bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." It's not the bread that we break and participation in the body of Christ.
Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the price you paid, bearing all my sin and shame. In love you came and gave amazing grace. Thank you for this love.
same way after supper he took the cup, saying, this cup is a new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever ye eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Is not the cup of thanksgiving for which we give thanks and participation in the blood of Christ.
What can wash the Jesus.
It's very interesting. Right in the sanctuary. It never happened before. God is right here. I have no problem to go back to the water one more time tonight. If you're ready today, accept my... What is holding you? What is holding you? My prayer is tonight or tomorrow morning, tomorrow 10:30, 10 o'clock, there's a baptism tomorrow morning. Come. Tonight I'm ready, tomorrow morning I'm ready. But do not allow one more day in your life. You're telling Jesus, if you come today, I have no part in you. Hallelujah. I see bread here, I see wine here. Hallelujah. You're going to sing one more song? And so we're going to spend some time with worship after. The first song, I want you to greet. Just say hello to people. Give a holy kiss. Or say can't, whatever you please. It's perfectly fine. Somehow communicate. Let them know. I am alive and you are alive. You are my brother. You are my sister.
God, we worship you, Jesus. Thank you for bringing us through this year, Jesus. Thank you for your strength and your grace and your compassion that has brought us through every struggle and trial that we've been through, God. Thank you that in the name of Jesus we have been victorious, God. Thank you that we have gone from glory to glory in your name, Jesus. God, thank you for all the heights that you brought us to this year, God. All the highs, all the lows, God, that you have been through this year, Jesus. Thank you for showing us how awesome you are.
glory and thanks for all that he has done for us. So I'd just like for everyone to stand church, please bow your heads and close your eyes, please, and just to give him praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We praise you, Father. We praise you, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we come to you, Lord, tonight, to sinners saved by your grace, Lord God. And Heavenly Father, you said those who hope in you, Lord God, will not grow weary, Lord God. And tonight, we put our hope, we put our trust in you, God, because there's none beside you, Father God. Heavenly Father, as we leave 2016, Lord God, we ask you, God, to help us not to look back like Lot's wife, Lord God, but to move forward, Lord God, in you. Lord, Father God, that you have greater, better plans for us, Lord God. Just help us to submit our lives to you, Lord God, to submit our ways, everything in your hands, Lord God. Let everything we do, Lord God, will be a reflection of you, Father God. We thank you, God, for this opportunity to worship and praise you this time, Lord God. And Father, as we're here, Lord God, help us to keep our eyes and our ears upon you, Lord God, seeking you for more, Lord God, loving you more, Lord God, and just giving you the thanks for everything in our lives. Father, we pray for our loved ones, Lord, and we pray for those who don't know you, Lord God, and we pray, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that this will be the year, Lord God, that many will come to know you, Lord God, and seek you, Lord God, in their lives. And Father God, no matter what comes our way, Lord God, help us to know you, Lord God, that you are still in control of every situation, Lord God. And help us, God, to just pray and keep a heart, Lord God, that's heaven-bound, Lord God. Lord, Father God, that day will come, Lord God, where we seek your grace and mercy, Lord God. We thank you for this opportunity, Lord God, and we pray for each and every one in this sanctuary, Lord God. We pray for our pastor, Lord God, as he preaches the word, Lord God, that, Lord, that hearts will be filled and lives will be touched and hearts will change, Lord God. Help us to leave this sanctuary, Lord God, new, with a new beginning, a new year, Lord God, and just love you more. We just want to thank you and praise God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Please
be assured to God. Hallelujah. 2016, goodbye. 2017. And I ask God, what do you want me to tell my people? 2017. Long time ago. I believe it was September, probably August, September. Word for you. My favor will be upon you. Yes. 2017, I'm expecting great things from God. Every year. 2005, I believe, started to preach with that vision, called to stand, called to serve, and called to send. That vision came when I was going from New York to Houston, Texas, in an airplane. Every year, in one word, most of you might have understood, I know. Because it was taking place in the spirit realm, step by step. Last year was by faith. But this year, not in the spirit realm, God is going to show you favor in every single day. A couple of passages has to remind you. Do you have the PowerPoint? I don't know which one I put it first. I believe Jeremiah chapter 30, 31 verse 2. This is what the Lord says. The people who survive the sword will find favor in the wilderness. I will come to give rest to you, Israel. Who are those people? Who are those people? Who are those people? Those people, God's promised people. Who are those people? Israel. Who are those people? My people, God says. Exodus chapter 3, verse 7. I have indeed seen the misery of my people
God called you my people. No one in the land, no one in the planet, God called my people. But I want to remind you, church, Jesus is calling you. They are my people. Hallelujah. You are part of the family of God. Hallelujah. They are the people who receive the promise from God. They are the people who experience the will of God. They are the people. I want you to think about the people of Israel in Egypt. 400, over 400 years. What did they do wrong? They didn't do anything wrong. It's not their fault. Many of us, same situation. The passage again, the verse, the Jeremiah passage says, they are the survivors. Survivors of what? I don't know, you remember Katrina? I don't know, you remember Sandy? I don't know, you remember the other earthquake took place in the land? I don't know, you remember the miscarriages. I don't know, you remember the divorces. I don't know, you remember the disappointing incidents. I don't know, you remember the pink slips. I don't know, you remember the loved one walked away. I don't know, you remember the days you stood in the doctor's office. I don't know, you remember that report you took in the hand and the call of God, what I'm going to do. I don't know, you remember the jobless days you sat. Or you haven't, right? The way you're sitting, I think you haven't faced any alarm. By 2016, December 31st, the last 2 hours, my dear beloved, we can say, I am a survivor.
Hallelujah.
I am a survivor.
Hallelujah.
They will try many things in my life, but I am standing in the presence of God, denying to proclaim the mercy of God.
Hallelujah.
My beloved, you are a survivor.
Hallelujah.
If you are breathing tonight, you are a survivor. I'm a survivor. They will try many things. Katrina came, Sandy came, divorce came, attack came, doctor's report came, but I am standing in the presence of God by the grace of God.
Hallelujah.
Who are these people? I received the promise. I have a promise. Hallelujah. I have the promise, but I'm a survivor. It's not my ability, it's not my might, it's not my capacity, but somehow it all came, but it went away. I am standing strong. You are standing strong tonight, my dear beloved. 2016, God gave you grace. You stand strong in the presence of God. Tonight to come and say, God, thank you.
Hallelujah.
I am a survivor. You are a survivor, people. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. People, as other people, again, let me go back. The place. You're asking God, here I am. Here I am. Here I am. You might be asking that. I don't know if you ever go to your place all the time and say, hey, here again I am. In that passage, Jeremiah 31, verse 2, it says, the highlighter, favor in the wilderness.
Hallelujah.
In the wilderness. Wilderness is a place, there's no life. Wilderness is the place of death. Wilderness is the place of danger. Wilderness is the place of loneliness. Wilderness is the place of hardship. Wilderness is the place of empty. Hallelujah. But if you look at the place you are, if you look at the place you are, it is empty. Hallelujah. There's nothing humanly you can say. There's nothing humanly, if you look and say you can accomplish anything. My God says in 2017, He did not say, I will change the place. He did not say He will change the place. He said, I will show you favor in the wilderness. I will show you favor in the wilderness. The place you are, the way you are, the place you are, God wanted to show you favor to you in 2017. My dear beloved, it is a word of the Lord for your family. It is a word of the Lord for your situation. It is a word of the Lord for your workplace. It is a word of the Lord tonight. I want you to receive it in your heart and declare it. Hallelujah. In my wilderness, my God is going to show favor.
Hallelujah.
The person, the people, I came out from NTT. Tragic situation as survivor. I am in a place of wilderness, but the path to the favor is not easy. See, everyone like to hear the promise. Everyone like to hear, you all are excited to hear, I am going to be favored by God. It's good, but there is a path. Because I am experiencing the favor of God, because I am able to receive the favor of God, I need to do something. Hallelujah. I am not like the other people. You are not like the other people. This is what the people with the favor will do. Exodus chapter 3 verse 7. I don't have all the references, but some of the references you will see on the screen. Some of them, I think, is in the bulletin also. That is why I put that in the reference in the bulletin. I want you to get this in 2017. That is the reason. See, because I am favored by God, because I was selected by God to experience the favor, this is what I'm going to do. 2017 as a church, 2017 as a family, 2017 as a child of God. Hallelujah. Because I am called by God to experience the favor of God. God wanted to do favor for you. Hallelujah. God wanted to give you favor. But because I am just chosen by God to experience the favor, this is what I'm going to do. Number one. Hallelujah. I don't mention the point. What's the next PowerPoint? Is it there? Yeah, it's there. They are chosen people of God. You are chosen by God, handpicked by God. My dear beloved, I want you to know you are chosen by God.
Hallelujah.
From eternity, you are chosen by God.
Hallelujah.
Do not allow the voice of the enemy to tell you something else. My dear younger generation, I want you to remember you are chosen by God in eternity. Hallelujah. He knows your name. He knows your name.
Hallelujah.
He knows how many hair you have. He knows everything about you. Praise you, God. I am a chosen by God. I am chosen generation, royal priesthood. Hallelujah. So I am a chosen person. I receive the promise of God. Because of that, I decided I'm a praying person.
Hallelujah.
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 Because I am a child of God, because I received the promise of God, I decided I am a praying person.
Hallelujah.
2017, I want you to get this. Reference is there. How you can experience the favor of God. Number one, then that person can pray to God and find favor with Him. If you decide today, I'm going to pray every single day. I'm going to spend some time. My prayer life is going to change in 2017 because God wants to do some favor in me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I decided to spend more time in prayer. Hallelujah. Because I experienced the favor of God. I don't know you have it there. Next PowerPoint. Yeah, you have it there. See, I decided to keep the commandment of God. Proverbs chapter 3 verse 1 through 4. My son, do not forget my teachings, but keep my commandments in your heart, for they will prolong your life. They will prolong your life many years and bring you peace and prosperity. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. Bind them around your neck, write them on your tablets of your heart, and then you will win favor. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Follow and keep the commandments. God's commandments of God given to you alive, you keep it. Let us keep the commandment of God. Moving on. Next one. I'm going to seek the wisdom of God. God give godly wisdom.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Proverbs 8 verse 35. For those who find me, find life and receive favor from the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There is some godly wisdom. Godly wisdom. Hallelujah. Godly wisdom. If you go to Empire State Building, and if you say, I'm a child of God, the Bible says, if I jump from here, angels will carry me.
Hallelujah.
You think angels are going to carry you? Yeah. But you, in case you are going there and fall from there, yes, God will carry you. Wisdom says, I got to be using my common sense. Minus 20 outside. Ice cold, I decided not to put a jacket outside. Mommy, I got pneumonia and I have a problem. Because God gave you wisdom.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Girls and boys, 2017, they're going to come. They're going to call you. Let's go. Use wisdom.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Say no, I don't like you. Get lost. Nothing wrong with that. God gave you wisdom.
Hallelujah.
God given wisdom because I'm a child of God, redeemed by God. Hallelujah. God wants to give me favor in 2017. Because of it, I'm going to use my wisdom.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Are you here?
Hallelujah.
You want the favor of God 2017?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Moving on. They diligently seek good. The people who want that or who wanted to experience the favor of God, they will take headache to do good. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's not easy to do good. Try it. Not easy. To do bad is very easy. Hallelujah. You ever have to teach your children to do bad things? Where did they learn from? And don't tell me that. They learn from parents. Yeah, I know. You don't have to teach the kids. See, I don't have to tell them to do this, but I have to tell them to sit quiet. Because we don't need to teach them to do bad things. See, we talk about children and we laugh. But how much bad things we do every day? We don't need to do anything to do bad things. But you need to decide, 2017. Hallelujah. Let the people do bad things to me. Let anybody say bad things about me. I have decided, 2017,
Hallelujah.
Jesus wants to show favor into my life. I'm going to do good. My friend, you do what you want to do. I have decided to follow Jesus, not turning back. 2017, I'm going to experience favor of God in my life. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Bible says again, they live righteously. Proverbs 14:9. Fools mock at the making amends for their sin, but goodwill is found among the upright. Hallelujah. So if you do these things, a couple of things that he will do for you. I don't have that much time to give you the whole thing. Probably tomorrow morning, the rest of it, and days to come, the rest of it, I'll pick up here and there. A couple of things I want to remind you.
Hallelujah.
God wanted to show you favor. 2017, this is what I want you to do.
Hallelujah.
You will have some memory things to do this. I have a magnet on the back, put it on your fridge to remind you that. You'll pick that up later. I'll give you that later. It's there. You can pick it up. There will be a clip, the pin you will get in a couple of weeks to remind you that too. But in 2017, this is what every single one of you listening to my voice, this family, I want you to do this. When you wake up in the morning, the first thing you need to say from your mouth, I'm going to walk
Hallelujah.
In the favor of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
365 days of 2017, 19, where I'm coming from, 19, my God, 1917, my father wasn't even born, 2017, every single day, this is serious, okay, because I wanted this to happen to me. I know God will do. A couple of things I'm going to share with you is going to happen, but this is what I want you to do. When you wake up in the morning,
Hallelujah.
Make a decision today. Today I'm going to walk in the favor of God.
Hallelujah.
2017, January 2nd. You will have roughly this magnet to your refrigerator or wherever you want. And you will have a pin in 2 weeks to remind you. But when you wake up, you need to make a decision. I'm going to walk in the favor of God.
Hallelujah.
2017, I'm going to walk in the favor of God. The people who experience the favor of God, go to the next slide. People who experience the favor of God, this is what we'll get. Genesis chapter 39, verse 21. Favor produces a supernatural increase and promotion. Joseph was in the prison. Joseph was a prisoner. The situation would never tell him he will be and get anywhere. But he decided, I'm going to walk in the favor of God. Joseph, if you study his life, he did what we just said. So God selected Joseph. Listen, in the prison, I'm going to make every single one of the leaders here to give you favor. Hallelujah. You might be in a prison situation. You might be in a situation you feel like you are in a prison. But I want to remind you, 2017, God is going to give you some people, and they will come, and they will give you favor. Moving on, number two. Hallelujah. Esther chapter 5, verses 8. If I have found the favor in the sight of the king, and if it pleases the king to grant me my petition, and to perform my request, let the king and Haman come to the banquet, and I shall prepare for them, and I will do tomorrow as the king has said. Many of you pray, work in different places. Many of you work in a situations the enemy or the people might not show any favor. But 2017, you're going to experience that because you're going to proclaim that. You're going to prophesy.
Hallelujah.
In your workplace, you're going to prophesy. In the morning, you wake up and say, I'm going to walk in the favor of God 2017. You walk there. God will do that for you. I experienced a numerous times in my life. My God is able to do the same thing in 2017. It is a prophetical word for each one of you. Whatever situation you will face in 2017, whatever challenges or whatever situation you will be, God will show you that.
Hallelujah.
Moving on. The next one.
Hallelujah.
Favor causes policies, rules, and regulations and law to be changed and reversed to your advantage. Hallelujah. Story is Esther is supposed to die. But God told Esther, the king told Esther, listen, rewrite the law. Rewrite the law for Esther.
Hallelujah.
2016, January. I want this girl to come here. How many of you know? You know her as a singer. You know her as a charming person. You know her as beautiful. But I'm going to go back to her painful life so you understand what favor means. A long time ago, she lost her earthly mother in a tragic accident.
Later in her life, she lost her earthly father. In a land, there's nobody else in that family. Grandma is there. Grandma raised her. There's nobody looked up to. Of course, the families are here. 2000 January, but some months earlier, Dad's sister came to know there's a chance I could bring her here. Did the process, did the paperwork, but there was a problem. It has to happen on the 18th, before the 18th birthday. That's the law of the land. That was January 28th. 2016, January 28th, she will turn into 18. So any legal work has to happen, and the person has to be in this land. In the land of America, then only it will work. Paperwork's done. January, things are not going good. Appointment was done to the embassy on the 12th, some 12th, I believe. Then some more papers needed. So the place is in Delhi. They live in the South Carolina. So what they decided, you know what we're going to do? By faith, we're going to pack. So they packed the suitcase, put everything, went to the embassy by faith, got the appointment 21st, then again need one more paper, done. Guess what? In North America, there's something called the snow. 1,800 planes canceled. There was snow in New York. No flight is coming to JFK. And look for a ticket. They will not issue a ticket until they get exit visa. So they will not issue, none of the airlines can release a ticket without this. So they cannot get it. But on the they packed the bag and they said, we want to get there. We prayed, and some of you know you prayed. 21st, went back again, finally got the visa, but again, no ticket. All the airlines are canceled, backed up 3 days, no ticket available. Think about it. But somehow, on the 25th, they got the ticket. Most of the flights were canceled. From Kuwait to New York is not confirmed. India to Kuwait was confirmed. By faith they went. But on the 25th, from Kuwait, one plane decided to come. They were able to land 3 days before, on the 18th birthday. So that is favor of God. That is a favor. You see, 3 days pass, cannot come. That is the law. But God did a favor because God is selected her from eternity. You are my child. Came to this family. There are many fathers, many mothers loving them. You ever see that to the story I told you? You didn't even know, right? Such a charming, loving, smiling. You know why? Because he experienced the favor of God.
Hallelujah.
Might be a beloved, Lord might be against you. The situation might be against you.
Hallelujah.
but no one can stand in front of you when there's no way God can open a way, because I'm a child of God, selected by God, we experience the favor of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 2017, you want to walk in your offices, I'm a child of God, experiencing favor of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, God. If I catch the next one, I don't think I can finish it. No, I'll pick up that tomorrow morning. I don't want to ruin it. It's all there. What's your king? Could you please come? Hallelujah. 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 Could you stand with me, all of you?
Hallelujah.
Can you tell the person who is standing next to you?
Hallelujah.
I'm a child of God, going to walk in favor.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to walk in the favor of God.
Amen.
I'm going to walk in the favor of God. I'm going to walk in the favor of God.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to walk in the favor of God. You're going to walk in the favor of God. Can you tell him you're going to walk in the favor of God? You're going to walk in the favor of God. You're going to walk in the favor of God. God selected me. I'm a child of God.
Sweet and precious name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hallelujah.